It was a Second World War airfield. It was a Cold War air base. It's been the home to Jaguars, Lightnings, Spitfires and Hurricanes. And for 66 years, there was continuous service for the Royal Air Force. This is possibly the last opportunity for you to see this most iconic of Norfolk airfields. Welcome to RAF Coltishall. So David, the first port of call on the tour will be right here at the control tower.
We'll stop around here and people will get the chance to look at the hangars behind us and the control tower that we're coming up to. They won't be actually able to go into the control tower on the day, but I can take you in there for a sneak preview if you like, and we can see the site from slightly higher up.
Yes, that'll be excellent, thank you. So David, it really does give us a complete overview here of the entire site, doesn't it?
Yes, this is the Cold War top to the control tower. The World War II control tower was down there, we can see that. The reason for doing Heritage Open Days this year is that before those redevelopments of the site start to take place, it's an opportunity for people this week to come round and see the site very much as it was in 2006 when the site closed. The only things that have changed really are the fact that the County Council is now looking after the site, doing landscaping, doing emergency repairs to the building, but it's pretty much unchanged as it was. Yes, this is one of the buildings that people will actually get into on Heritage Open Days, and the reason for coming in here is it's one of the four hangars that were built, and particularly to see these fantastic pieces of wall art.
Yes.
Done for a big party in this hangar when the Jaguar squadrons returned from the first Gulf War. Spitfires and Hurricanes would have come in here to be maintained. During the war, they're actually dotted around the airfield in what we call the fighter pens, and in fact, we're going to go and see one of those next.
Great. Yeah. Let's head off. David, this is quite unique to Coltishall then.
It's a remarkable survival. There is another one on the airfield, but it's not half as good as this. This is really looking absolutely fantastic now. It's just had some trimming done, so all of the ivy and the undergrowth has been cut back, so it's really looking its best now for Heritage Open Days.
So David, this area was what is known as a fighter pen. This is where the aircraft would come in and be protected, is that right?
Yes, you'd have one fighter on each side of the pen, and the whole idea here is that you've got your aircraft dotted around the airfield. This is passive defence. You're preventing enemy aircraft from coming in and taking out your fighters by dotting them in these pens all the way around the airfield.
So these are actual sandbags but filled with concrete?
Yes, absolutely right. And once they've solidified, they're really strong. So a very good defence.
They really do look like blocks of concrete, but actually yeah. They're originally a sandbag which has been filled. There's a pebble effect or something on the top of it here.
That's just the mix that went into the concrete. And it does vary, actually, as you look round. Some are slightly sandier than others. So it's all very rough and ready, but very effective.
The Heritage Open Days offer us all an opportunity to visit unique locations. And today, here at RAF Coltishall, it's been very special. We've not been able to see everything that you will see on one of the tours, so do go ahead and book for Thursday and Friday this week and visit this iconic Norfolk airfield.